Hello everybody, Kai's23 here, and welcome back to Pantropy. Now, this is literally the day after I recorded the last one. They released a new patch, and in it, it introduced the assault rifle. Fairly easy to make. I mean, it's no worse than, like, the spear gun. Just takes a few more materials. But it's unfortunately the nighttime when I decided to start, of course. But one of the biggest things that was introduced in this patch, it's still dark, are new tier 1 base parts called composite, like composite parts, wall, foundation, floor, except for the door. The door is still the same one. And same thing with ramps. That's why it's kind of like funny looking. When it's daytime, I'll show you better. But an inclusion to that, I don't know why my thing keeps scrolling down, they introduced something else that's new, which I never exactly know where it is. Oh, yep, construction composite uses the feldspar now, so we don't have to keep making all those fire bricks from the feldspar, because the metal construction elements uses construction composite. But the thing I'm looking for is, there it is, wearable light. This is a new thing that was introduced. Huh. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so while that's crafting, I've gotten back all the weapons. I remade them. Nail gun, spear gun, assault rifle, and rail gun. Did I call this one a... Never mind. I also made the command tool, the CMT there. Which can repair, which is really cool looking. And I've also made, oh hello, an advanced crafting station. I've never used this before. This is one of the things I haven't used with the new update. Ah, does it need power? Your queue has to be empty. Your queue has to be empty. Okay. Okay. Oh, shoot. Is it going to do this? This is one thing that needs to be fixed. Because, I mean, now it's on the screen. You know what? I could just sit down there for now. Aw, man. Oh, hey. There we go. Okay, so let's... Weird. Oh. Okay, so that's really reducing the time. Yeah, that whole dragging thing is gonna get annoying. But I'll show you this. This is really cool. You put this in the light spot, turn off this, and bam! It is a very bright light. Make it tell. Oh, that's interesting. I didn't realize that because I've been using night vision so much. The composite bases are basically like sandstone looking things almost. Okay, switch that off. Go outside. Ah, the beautiful sunset. Sunrise. Better not be sunset. So, we're going to make a few composite base parts. Gonna craft you and a wall. Because now I can repair it, which will make damage testing so much easier. Nothing has been added to the map yet. There's the ore spawn still, but those have all been the same. And boop. And I can easily destroy this thing instead of having to completely destroy everything. I can just use the command tool. So these have 500 HP as compared to a normal base wall. I don't know if the like armor value for them has been implemented yet. So, let's begin testing. So, 500. We'll stand right in this middle part. My bad. Did 5 HP. This one. Huh. So apparently the repair tool is not working yet. Okay, so we're going to be doing the same thing. I just did no damage to that. There we go. About 14 damage. Which I think is about the normal one. You know what we could do? Since I'm stupid. While we're waiting for that to go. So 5 and 14. Oh, that was loud. Is there someone else? 71. So that one does 10. So we have 5, 14, and 10. And of course, the railgun's gonna be like 100 something. So we're at 471. Oh my god. Yeah. Railgun does a buttload of damage. Why can't I make a wall? Oh, I need 5. You know what? This is where this advanced crafting station will come in. Input. Get maximum. Craft now. 5 seconds per. Can I just leave that there? And then, okay, there's 3 in there now. If I walk away, do. Also, oh, wait, no, it's not supposed to go there. The devs, when they reset the servers and stuff after every patch, only the world gets erased. The player character data stays. So I need to remember to pick up most of my stuff. Well, stuff that I can pick up. Hey, it does work. Did not know that did that. Nope. Okay. Yeah, this isn't going to be a very long episode. I'm just showing you guys the new stuff with the wall. Does it work now that it's lower? No? Think there's anything I need. No, not gonna destroy it. Does this do any damage? No? Okay. One thing I actually do need to get done though is I have 70. It should be good enough for now. Gosh darn it. Well, now we'll always know we have 31 composite materials just floating next to our axe. Which, let me pull up the assault rifle and go outside real quick. I think they've updated the model of the hand, because look at that. It looks a lot more detailed, which is nice. Hey, there we go. So a few bugs still to work out. Just remember to shift click. Shoot. Meant to do that. Craft now. Yay. And then one more thing I want to test is I'm just going to build a quick little base over here and then test something. Now, as far as I know, there's like 2 other people on that I've seen. Well, when I logged in, I saw it said two people. But I haven't actually seen anybody yet. Of course. Oh, I see a base down there. I'm just going to do something just for the heck of it. I don't think it'll actually work. I wonder if that reached. It'd be kind of funny if I hit it. But, after we get this wall made, I want to test and see if, when you destroy the foundation, if everything will destroy itself too. Just to see if that's been implemented yet. I'm assuming so, but, you know, I got to do my testing. All element. Alright. Okay, then we're gonna... And then we need another wall. And then we need a door frame. And then we need a floor. Yay! Yeah, forgot that closes automatically. And of course, my stupid freaking mouse wheel is still borked. Okay, so we said this one did 4 to 5. I haven't built a new wall since the update. These have 1,000 HP now. Really? So they do about the same damage. Okay. So there's really no big difference yet besides... whatchamacallit there? HP. 7. 8. No. 9. Okay, so we're going to be using the railgun for this just because it does it the fastest. So 383. I just completely missed that. I hit the back wall. I'm a terrible shot at close range, apparently. 266. $149. $32. Should we kill with the nail gun? Oh. Yep, it does work. Oh, that's cool. Oh, it even leaves chunks you can stand on. Now that you don't see too often. Oh. Now that was a lot of resources used. Just to let you know. A lot of feldspar. Okay. Take this stuff. Now, something I actually haven't made yet is the electric smelters and the thermal generator. I haven't made them yet. Wow, I ran out of feldspar. Okay, so we can make 5 construction materials. Ain't getting far with that. So I just want to take a quick look around. I did see that some people are making some really cool bases. I still don't want to really build a big, big base just because of how many updates they've been pushing out recently. It's just not worth it to keep building up that big base and stuff. Maybe if I was playing with some other people, like actually had a group of people, we were all working together, yeah, I would build something every time just for the heck of it. But me by myself, just mostly testing out this stuff for right now, not gonna worry about it. Once they're able to start saving the world with every update and not having to wipe it, then I'll worry. But until then, shut up, chair. My chair likes to squeak. So they did mention that in one of the updates, you'll be able to craft glow sticks. Don't know why you would want to, but I'm going to assume that it's just, like, super cheap and easy. And, you know those trees, I can't remember which part it was, that we saw, that glow in the dark? I'm gonna assume you have to collect something from those. I gotta get used to pressing 5 instead of 4 for the railgun. Let's see if we can do this this time. So it takes about 5 railgun shots to take down 500 HP. Because nothing has armor values yet. That's gonna be something that comes later, as we just saw. Excuse me. So let's go over here. Go over here. All right, we're gonna take out this corner one. Where is it? There it is. Right, yeah. Not gonna move. Two. Now, I don't think they fixed the turrets, so turrets can shoot through some parts of inanimate objects. I missed that one. Oh. No. There it is. So we can get over here, but again, there's nothing to do here yet. That's what a turret looks like. Keeps you up. Ow, ow, ow. These are the loot crates. Can open them? Well, hush my mouth. I will sort that stuff out later. Wow, that's a lot of materials. But hey, we got to the top. Hehehehe. Okay, let's get out of here before that turret comes back to life. Wow, okay, so loot boxes are working. Where else did we see loot boxes? There's that base along the back we can go check out real quick. If free loot and stuff, I'll take it. Alright, real quick. Combine some of this stuff. That was all? That was all. Okay. Wow. These things are super hard to make. The standard crafting CPUs? Of course they're not on there. CP. Standard crafting CPU is the one that takes an advanced CPU, four basic CPUs, four electronics, and two gold. We got 19 of them for free. I will take that. Wow. I just want to see. Oh, and apparently that base there is actually another YouTuber space. Saw his video posted on the actual Facebook page, I guess you call it. The page that the devs run on Facebook. They posted his video. I was like, yeah, I'll check it out, see what he's doing. That's his base right there. So I thought that was pretty cool. Is he on? I actually want to see something. I want to see if my railgun hit his base. I mean, I doubt it, but let's just go see real quick. If it did, I'm going to be shocked at how far this thing can shoot. There has to be some kind of drop off. No, it doesn't look like he's on. Thousand, thousand. Nope, I missed. Yep, I missed. Kinda can get into his base pretty easily, though. All I would have to do is just place the foundation and a ramp. Or just even a ramp or stairs or something. So let's go raiding the base. I mean, So I'm part of the Discord chat for this game. I ask them questions, I report problems to them that I see. And something that people keep saying is, like, are the loot boxes working yet? Are they gonna be working? And the devs keep saying, no, they're not working yet. So I'm kind of curious as to what that whole thing was that I just collected. Which is one of the main reasons why I want to go down here and test this base. If the loot boxes are working, that'll save me a lot of time with setting up some of the stuff. And possibly building a new weapon or mech when they introduce them. I do need to get some electric stuff going. What I might do now is get all my ores smelted, make all of the stuff for next time, keep it all in my inventory, and next time we start up. Okay. That was random. And then next time the whole world resets and we have to start again, I'll be set. I'll have s stuff set up. But I will have to go mining to get some more feldspar. Because right now I do not have enough to make another base. Doesn't help that I just used a bunch of it to destroy. But it was worth the test, since I hadn't done it yet. And really, it's really not that hard to go get feldspar. Every node gives you feldspar. That is a very square looking rock. I think it's just a shadow, though. So I might just go around to collect some coal ores. What the heck? Yeah, they have the monster models, but they don't have them like animated with an AI yet. So I don't know when those are actually going to be implemented. When they are, having stuff early is going to be nice to have. I don't remember where this base was. Oh boy. Maybe through the trees. I'm really hoping that the base exp or not the base. The map expands soon. 'Cause as it stands right now, it is kind of small for a survival map. Granted, there's not that many people on here yet. But when there gets to be more people, everybody's going to be running into each other here. And so far, from what I've been seeing with the community, is everyone's very nice. They're like, hey, I'm just starting off, can someone help me? And in chat, Meanie's like, hey, I'll come find you, come help me at my base and stuff. Or, start with mining some ore nodes and building yourself a basic base with the composite materials. This was just today. So it was new stuff. And I'm sitting here, I'm like, wow, I'm gonna love this community. As long as it doesn't turn into eventually everyone just killing everyone for everything, I'll be happy. But as it stands right now, the people in here are nice. I rarely talk in chat, just because usually people beat me to the punch. Because I'll be sitting there sitting crafting stuff and not paying attention, and the chat will be going like, oh, oops, I missed it. That another base over there. No, it's an R node. There is the base. Thankfully, this thing doesn't have turrets yet. One thing I would not mind seeing is a like a button to see who's online. I don't know, I just like knowing who's online, because then I get an idea of where they are. Like, the YouTuber, I know his name. It's like Deuce WTF, I think it was. That's the YouTuber. And I know that's his base there. So if he was online, oh hey, I know his base there. I don't have to go near it. And stuff like that. Ugh. I cannot wait till mechs come in. Hopefully that they're faster than walking. All right, we're here. So let's see. You do get stuff from here. Whoa, that's a lot of stuff. Okay, so you can shift click some stuff, but not all of it. Like that. Okay, it's past a certain point that you can shift click. Really weird. So that was just a bunch of free crafting materials. Which, like I said, will help me get set up for the next time the map is wiped. The one ore that I can never seem to find too often is uranium. Uranium, uranium, eh. No. Just because it's for the most powerful weapon in the game right now. Also, that light is just really. It reminds me of a horror game with this light. The flashlight going like this and stuff, and it's just waving back and forth. But the fact that I can look down and I don't see it turned down is just so weird. Ooh. Are you uranium? That's why I prefer this. Ah. Note yourselves, do not sit too close when looking at the screen. Oh, that's bright. Please be uranium, please be uranium, please be uranium. No, you are iron. But yeah, that's it for this update. Oh, they did change what the iron ore looks like too. Forgot to mention. I think they changed the sounds too. Just had to get a few extra swipes in there, you know. Alright. No, there's no weather in the game yet. They said they were thinking about it, but it's a low priority. I mean, I can understand that. Get gameplay out before adding little odds and ends that don't really make a difference. Well, I mean, it could make a difference, but you get what I'm saying. I would just love to have like the rain. I'm a person who loves the rain. I love the sound of rain. And just being able to sit in one of those bases and have the windows there with like one of the windowed roofs that are like it's a solid roof but it has like the glass in it. Just being able to sit there and watch the rain would be really cool. But only if you can get the rain right. Some games do rain very poorly, some do them very well. So, if weather is ever introduced, I would hope that the devs can do a good job with this. With the way I'm seeing this game is going to be absolutely amazing. I mean, there's still a few odds and ends that need to be worked on, such as. Oh, there it is. I was going to say, they fixed that? Now, a few trees still need some collision detection on them. I mean, this. The starship here is really cool, but there's really nothing to it right now. Same thing with all the base, the three bases that are in the game. Again, they just released the stuff, so. Is that someone's base? Can't tell. No, it's a rock. I have terrible eyesight, even with my glasses on. I have a big monitor. I still can't see anything. But yeah, next time we come back, it'll probably be a new server. I'll have stuff set up though. Like, I will get the electric furnace, I will get the generators and stuff. I'll have stuff set up. They'll wipe the server. I'll be set in order to go next episode for next episode and stuff. And I won't have to start in the complete darkness. Now, the one thing that's been bugging me is This is my fourth chest light I've had to make. Little glitch in the system where you log off with a chest light and come back on, it's gone. You saw how cheap it was to make, so I'm not worried about it. But, every little bug is a bug. But yeah, thank you guys so much for joining me, and like I said, next episode, be on a new server, probably be a new base. I'll have electric stuff set up, and we'll go testing from there, depending on what is added. So, till next episode. Wait. You know what? Before we end the episode, we have to shoot down the dropship once. We have to shoot it down once. We're gonna make this a new tradition for this game. Every episode, the dropship must be shot down once, as long as we can shoot it down. Now we just gotta find it. Which, this is why I can't wait until we get flying game. Yeah! Ooh. That's right, this is supposedly supposed to have loot stuff in it. Excuse me? Where are you going? I thought your crash site was over here. There was a light on in there. Yeah, there's that base and there's another one over there. Little community getting started. I thought you crashed over here. Nah, forget it. There was no crates last time anyways. All right. So, until next episode, take it easy.